Hi, I'm Alex with Kimray. Today we're going to install an electric pilot. For this application, we'll be using a Valvcon electric actuator with the R2L and a 2-inch Kimray high pressure control valve. For this process, you'll need wire strippers, a 7/64 Allen wrench, and a termination screwdriver. For this setup process, you'll want to have already calibrated your Valvcon actuator. First, thread the pilot onto your Valvcon. Depending on your site, you may need to mount it closer to the transducer. Take the wires coming from your analog pressure transducer and terminate them to the pilot in the analog in positive and analog in negative terminals. For this video, we're going to simulate the transducer signal. Connect another set of wires to the analog out positive and analog out negative terminals. Run these wires to the position control, terminals 15 and 16. Connect the power wires to the actuator in terminals 19 and 20. For this installation, we are using 24 volts DC. The pilot can share power with the Valvcon. Run these wires to the pilot and terminate them alongside the incoming power on the voltage in and ground terminals. Now we're ready to turn the power on and set up the pilot. First, push the select button until you reach the sensor setup, then push the up button. Push the up button again until you reach pressure, and then hit the select button. Select PSI. Now use the up and down buttons to set the maximum and minimum working pressures of your pressure transducer. For this example, we'll say the transducer maximum is 2000 PSI and minimum is 0 PSI. Now you will be on the application menu. Use the up and down buttons to cycle through and select your application. Select back pressure. The next menu is for set value. Use the up and down buttons to scroll to your desired set point. We'll use 650 PSI. Press select to enter that value. Now press select until you get to the mode menu. Then use the up and down buttons to cycle through and select manual mode. Move the controller output to 50%. This will open the valve approximately halfway and allow pressure to flow through. Press select. Hit select again until you get back to mode menu. Press the up button and select auto tune. The pilot will now send varying signals to the valve to see how it reacts. This should take 10 to 15 seconds. Once it has completed auto-tune, it will automatically move to run mode and begin controlling your set value. Now your pilot, actuator, and valve are set up for back pressure regulation. You can leave it on this screen and it will move to standby mode after approximately 4 minutes. If you ever need to change your set value, you won't need to run auto-tune again. You'll only need to do that if you change your valve or trim size. Thanks for watching. If you have any questions, contact your local Kimray store or authorized distributor.